What's up, guys? I'm Christian with River Pools, and today we're talking about all things saltwater pools. This is 2 Minutes in the Pool. I like that the sun is finally out. Okay, real quick before we get going, if you find that this video was helpful for you, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Facebook and Instagram for more educational pool content from us here at River Pools. Now, saltwater pools, we're gonna talk a little bit about the chemistry, the lifespan, the cost, just pretty much in general, what you need to know about saltwater pools. However, this is an extensive article that we've done, and I've put a link down in the description. It's down in the description for YouTube, and it's up there for Facebook. So check out the full article when we're done, as I'm going to try to summarize and fit it all inside 2 minutes. Hence the name of the show, 2 Minutes in the Pool. All right, so you know the deal. I'm going to set a 2-minute timer on my phone and try to get to the bottom of it before the jingle goes off. Hey Siri, set a 2-minute timer.
Okay, your timer is set for 2 minutes.
Fantastic. Let's roll. Okay, first and foremost, what is a saltwater pool? Well, it's a pool that uses salt, converts it to chlorine, which then becomes your sanitizing agent. And how does it do that? By using a salt chlorine generator attached to your filtration system. The water, the salt water, enters one side of the salt chlorine generator, comes out the other side, and through the magic and power of electricity and science, chlorinated water comes out the other side. So it still uses chlorine, just like a traditional pool, to sanitize your water. It is going to have a slightly salty taste, but it's only got about 1/10 the amount of salt of the ocean. So think of it more along the salinity of a teardrop. So that's how a salt chlorine pool gets its sanitizing agent, through a salt chlorine generator. I won't go into the nitty-gritty sciencey details that's in the article, but let's talk about what type of salt you need to use for your pool. First and foremost, you're just simply going to put salt into your pool water and then let the components take it from there. But the type of salt you need to use is the purest you can get, and we recommend using mined salt. Not solar salt, not mechanical salt, but mined salt with a purity of 99% or higher. We're not talking about using rock salt, which you would typically use maybe for making ice cream or something like that, but use mined salt at a purity of 99% or higher. Anything other than that is going to give you headaches in terms of the chlorine's effectiveness after it's been converted from the salt. So how much does the salt chlorine generator cost? Well, the initial cost could be anywhere from $600 to $2,000. Now that's quite a range, but we're talking about brands and any other add-on components, automation, things like that you want to consider to have with your system. So you still have a ballpark, $600 to $2,000. However, in terms of operating that pool system during the year, you know what? I didn't think I was going to make it on this one. I just thought the odds were stacked against me. But you want your answer, so we're going to keep going on this. And we'll call it 3 minutes in the pool, 4 minutes in the pool, whatever it takes to get you the information you need. So we talked about the initial upfront cost to purchase the salt chlorine generator system, $600 to $2,000. But let's talk about the annual operating cost. It could be $50 to $100 per year versus a traditional chlorine system, which could cost you anywhere from $250 to $300 per year. Now, over time, over the lifespan of the salt chlorine generator, comparing saltwater pools to traditional chlorine pools, you're going to spend about the same. Now, why is that? If we're saving during the year, well, that's because the cell itself needs to be replaced anywhere from 3 to 7 years. Parts in here do break down over time, and so by the time you weigh out the actual cost, you're spending the same amount of money versus a traditional chlorine system. But you should weigh in the ease of maintenance. And that's gonna take us to the pros and cons of a salt chlorine pool. So the advantages are the water feels silky smooth, it's incredibly clear, and they're incredibly easy to maintain. They're virtually hands-off other than you monitoring your pool chemicals to adjust the amount of electricity going to your generator, which will produce either more chlorine or less chlorine depending on the amount of usage and other contaminants that your pool has to deal with. So just some weekly monitoring is all you really need to maintain this. So perhaps the savings in time would edge and outbeat a traditional chlorine pool. So the downside of a salt chlorine generator, other than the fact that they're more expensive up front, is, well, folks tend to set and forget that they need to monitor their pool chemistry. And so what can happen is the chlorine itself can creep up into a higher level than necessary, and even a dangerous level sometimes, or the pH could creep up and get a little out of balance. So as long as you remember to maintain and check your chemicals, you're gonna be in good shape. On the other, another downside could be its ability to work in a pool with an automatic pool cover. They do work alongside each other very well, except you're gonna need to pay a lot more diligent attention to the components of your pool cover. A lot of moving parts, all made of metal, and of course we all know that metal doesn't like salt water. So just taking good care of the automatic pool covers and its components, and you should be good to go. So where do you go from here? Well, just like I mentioned earlier, there's a link to the article down here for YouTube. It's up there for Facebook. And if you go to that article down at the bottom, we have suggested articles and other readings all about salt chlorine pools, salt itself, all the different components, everything you need to know to become educated. I'm Christian with River Pools. We blew the budget on 2 minutes today, but nonetheless, you've got your answer about saltwater pools and everything about them. We'll see you in the next episode. Catch the wave.